Suppose someone asked you to add the numbers 259 and 374 in your head. How would you do it? You may try to mentally line up the numbers and then add the corresponding digits for units, tens, and hundreds. Whatever the method, chances are that this task will be challenging. That's because you have to keep a lot of information around. Not only the exact numbers to be added, but also the intermediate products of the addition. This task is difficult because it overloads your working memory. Human working memory is a buffer or scratchpad in which the mind stores information relevant to the current task. The working memory buffer has a limited capacity. Think of it as an egg carton with a small number of slots, say 6. The actual capacity will vary from person to person. If a task requires more than 6 items of information to be kept in the working memory, some of them won't fit in our 6-slot carton, and we may not be able to remember them when we need them. As a result, we may end up working harder to recover that data. And we may take longer to do the task, or we might make mistakes. In our addition example, we may end up dumping out a carry or a digit from one of the original numbers and produce the wrong answer, or have to start all over again. A UX concept that is related to that of working memory is cognitive load. If a task incurs a high cognitive load, it usually means that it puts a high burden on the working memory. To make the experience pleasant and usable, designers must make sure that a user's working memory won't be overloaded. It's easy to say limit the working memory burden, but certain tasks are naturally more complex than others. How can we help users get around their working memory limitations? In our original addition example, we cannot change the task. The addition is what it is. But we can make it easier by providing pen and paper so people can write down the numbers and the intermediate products in the task without having to store them in their working memory. The paper acts as a physical scratch pad, a fake working memory, an extension of it. It's what we call a type of external memory. External memory refers to any tool or UI feature that allows users to explicitly save and access information needed during a task. A typical example of a web task involving a high working memory burden is item comparison. The user has to weigh in the pros and cons of several alternatives and choose the best. Whether comparing hotels, shoes, or insurance plans, comparison involves remembering the available options and deciding which option combination is optimal. Tools such as comparison tables are a form of external memory. They allow users to select a set of items of interest and explicitly compare their pros and cons lined up with each other in an easy-to-see table. Different tasks have different working memory requirements. Designers must understand what kinds of information users will need to keep in their working memory as they attempt to reach their goals on a website. And they will need to provide UI features that act as external memory to help people offload that burden and perform the task faster.